go up to be analysed. I would rise at 5 or 6 in the morning, plant myself in front of the television for hours on end. I would watch anything on the television without any interest whatsoever. I had no motivation and couldn't be motivated to do anything, even though there was plenty to do. I just felt really low. I was once asked if I ever considered suicide during this time. The strange thing is that I hadn't considered suicide, but I had worked out how I would do it. Eventually, I was persuaded by friends and family to visit my GP, who diagnosed that I was suffering from depression. That meant that within a very short period of time, I too had become a head case. Of course, people asked me the usual question, like, what was I depressed about? But I had learned the hard way that it doesn't work like that. My GP put me on medication and referred me to a counsellor. After a few meetings with him, he persuaded me that I should try following new horizons, and I reluctantly agreed. I had never heard of following new horizons and knew nothing at all about it, except what the counsellor told me, which was basically they provided activities and training for people with mental health problems. It took a lot of hope on my part to make my first visit, not knowing what to expect and what sort of environment I would be in. I was not looking forward to it at all. When I arrived, I was introduced to the staff and the different courses available were explained to me. Everyone and everything was very relaxed and casual, with no pressure whatsoever. I have to admit that my initial reaction was that I shouldn't be here, as there are a lot of people with a lot worse problems than me here. After talking to a few of them, it was clear that many of them also thought that they shouldn't be there. So we were all in one boat. After discussions with some of the tutors about my likes and interests, it was agreed that I should join two courses, gardening and Tiffany glass. Again, no pressure from anyone. Both classes were made up of people with a variety of different needs, and we were all novices at what we were doing, and everyone was starting at the same level. After just a couple of classes in each subject, I was hooked. The gardening class was very hands-on and took in everything from sowing seeds to harvesting crops. The tutor answered any question and explained everything in everyday language, and I really started to get an interest, something which hadn't been there for a very long time. The Tiffany class was something else, something which I had absolutely no experience of, but seemed to have a flair for. It required a lot of imagination and a lot of different skills had to be mastered. Again, the tutor was brilliant and helped along at every stage of the process. Nothing was too much baller, and within a couple of weeks, everyone in the class had produced their own first piece of Tiffany glass. In the gardening, a lot of the classes involved working in groups, whereas in the class, most of the work involved working on your own ideas and getting on with it. Both of these situations I eventually realised suited me great. During both classes, everyone started to know everyone else and become friendly. Previously, when we were all individuals, we were still all individuals, but now a group. The staff throughout the complex would offer support when needed and would have tried to answer any questions on any subject if possible. Something which always amazed me is the staff's interest in each individual during the courses. I was there only a couple of weeks, but I had met a member of the staff for the first time. "Hello, Billy," she said without introduction. So how good did that make me feel? So, how has Spoiler Rises helped me and how have I changed? For a start, in the summer past, I constructed 4 years of beds at home, garden beds at home, and started to grow my own vegetables. Brilliant. Would I have had the energy or motivation to do that without new horizons? No, I wouldn't. I've also started to collect tools for working with glass at home, which I eventually hope to start making small Tiffany glass projects. Would I have had the energy or motivation to do that without new horizons? No, I wouldn't. My attitude towards people with different mental problems has completely changed. This has come about by meeting and associating with them and having a bit of crack together. Also, the realization that they think I'm as big an oddball as I think they are has helped. Again, all this has come about through new horizons. Even though my attitude has changed, I know that there's still going to be a hell of a lot of work done to begin to change the attitude of the wider community. We all notice classes, attitudes when we had our classes. We see outside vendors coming into top-up machines, trying their best to avoid eye contact with us and trying to get in and out quickly before they're struck down. Unfortunately, I understand this attitude, but how do you change it? People come in for lectures unconnected with the centre. Again, usually, eyes down and get into the lecture room as quickly as possible. Probably disappointed that the place wasn't in Bellin as I would have expected. A few of us have actually talked about putting on a show to give them what they expect, but I'm not sure this would have put out with money. From a personal point of view, I now don't have to sit in the house all week, but we look forward to some place to go two or three times a week. A place to explore different interests and meet different people, thanks to New Horizons. My overall form and condition has improved dramatically since starting to attend at New Horizons. My confidence is coming back, and I would like to think that I am on the way to full recovery. For me, following New Horizons could have literally been a lifesaver. So finally, thanks for your time, and I hope that my story has helped you understand and realise that mental health problems can affect anyone of any age at any time, and not necessarily through any fault of their own. Thank you.
Specialties and was a nurse manager for a recruitment consultancy. I completed my degree in health studies, which I'm very proud of. However, all of this proved very stressful for me, and after a period of unwell, my psychiatrist and I agreed I should take a complete break from the working world. My community psychiatric nurse, Brenda, suggested Action Mental Health, New Horizons, New York. I'd been away from work for 1 month and found it very hard to fill my day. I went to AMH Newry and got to speaking to Alex, the client development coordinator. He explained to me what AMH was all about and how it brought structure to my week. I was really excited about this, and instead of waiting on the post, I hand delivered the referral form to my CPM to be completed and left back to AMH Newry. I started with half a day per week doing the CLIP computer course, and over the period of 2 years, increased my days to three as I built up my stamina. After 1.5 years at AMH, I completed the Clayton ECDL computer qualifications. Rosalind, the employment officer, suggested that I do a voluntary placement to build up my skills and get to be at work again. Meeting my tutor said I'd be able to do the MBQ level 1 and 2 in business administration whilst in my placement. I really enjoyed the MBQ and got to love my placement. My placement was in the cash office in Devon and Newry. Rosalind came out on various occasions to make sure I was settling in well, and Mary came to my placement to speak to my supervisor to see the type of evidence I'd be able to gather for the MVQ. My supervisor Karen helped me greatly in gathering evidence, and I was able to finish the MVQ level 1 and 2 in 1 year. The placement was initially for 4 hours per week, and after a few months, I increased it to 8 hours per week. In December of last year, my placement finished. I spoke to my manager, Leslie, and she was able to give me 4 hours per week in a pay room. I was over the moon, and from December I've been working 4 hours per week, along with doing an extra shift Christmas Eve to help out. Almost 2 weeks ago, I got my first pay packet in 3 years, and it felt really good to be back to work. My leaving date from AMH Newry is the end of March, and as well as working in Debenhams, I'm doing other personal development and recreational courses. This includes a walking group, a catering course, which I'm thoroughly enjoying and will help me with my come down and meet with my friends. Also a course on stress awareness. Other courses I've completed are personal confidence and development, healthy living, and money management. Courses in watercolour, silk painting, and creative writing have also proved very useful and enjoyable to me. I really appreciate my time with AMH Newry, and all the staff and Brian the manager have been more than pleasant and good-natured in helping me. As well as the staff at AMH Newry and tips from other clients, I could not have got this far without the good support from my friends Paul and Michelle and my family. I cannot emphasise enough how AMH has changed changed my life for the better, both in my working life and my social interactions. I hope other people who have gone through a trying time in their life are able to avail of good services given the AMH, which to me are life changing. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm very pleased to be here today on behalf of the Reverend employers who are involved with Action Mental Health. In various regions throughout Northern Ireland, groups of employers in the area formed into local employers forums to coordinate our activities as a work with our nearby Action Mental Health offices. In the South Island, South Armagh region, we have companies such as Seeka, Packaging, Glen Electric, the local health trusts, and some of the larger employers who are working with us. And many of those employers will tell you that today they face an increasing number of requests from voluntary organisations seeking their assistance in helping them achieve their objectives. There's great willingness in most companies, and especially from individual employees, to work with groups that focus on particular areas of need. Working with Action Mental Health and New Horizons is a very, very rewarding experience. As an employers forum, we meet with representatives of Action Mental Health to understand their needs and those of their clients. We sometimes find that it is possible to provide duties that are used to keep clients busy at the Action Mental Health premises, or on other occasions we find that we're able to accommodate people within our own workplace. In either case, we always feel we're making a contribution to something very worthwhile. We fully understand the importance of a structured day for someone who is suffering from mental health issues. You've heard of Nicola's experience of being a work placement, and her story mirrors what we have found to be the case. We found that someone who feels ready to return to workplace after having a mental health issue derives tremendous benefit from being able to ease into a workplace in the company of workers who are competent within their roles. An environment such as that is not too demanding, and there's not a big expectation that the newcomer will immediately begin to contribute to greater productivity. Over a period of time, work practices are developed. Usually the client will become more used to the routine aspects of the role and then will progress to tackling some of the more difficult elements of the job. In this way, they will again become used to the routine of a working environment and gain an appreciation of how various individual tasks combine to achieve the overall objectives of the organisation. And it's important to say that this is not a one-way process. As well as being helpful to the AMH clients, companies participating in programmes such as this usually benefit from seeing their own employees develop skills in the area of training and delegation, as they teach their new colleague how to do the job. It's not always possible for an employer to be able to add responsibilities such as this to middle-ranking administrative or manual roles, but working with AMH does provide this opportunity. We know from the publication of the University of Ulster's report last week that Northern Ireland has one of the highest incidents of mental illness in the developed world. It's stated that there's a cost to our economy here of £380 million per annum. Now, the work that many employers are doing is needed to help organisations such as Action Mental Health provide workplace opportunities to their clients and bring them back into the workforce. Unfortunately, there is a limit to what we can do. The private sector in Northern Ireland is operating in a very difficult area. We're beset by many problems in the present economic climate. We're much smaller in size than the public sector, and what opportunities we can provide should be dwarfed by the extent and the cooperation and assistance that has been given by public services in Northern Ireland. Is that what's happening? I don't think so. There's a need for all of us, especially public sector workplaces, to accept the challenge of helping those in need of assistance. Those who are able to should give, and those who need should get. We're probably in the right place at the moment to appeal to the public sector in Northern Ireland to play their part, and not only in providing financial assistance, but also in allowing workplace opportunities to many who will derive benefits that will allow them to